State Department. Nate Thomas is on the front row alongside Doug Curry and getting ready to help turn a loose and turn the ignition key on an exciting mini stock feature. Dave Durable.
We have turn number four. We are on our way. Chris Ivey grabs the early advantage. Here comes Kennedy and Sands to go to one.
And Curry is pretty strong, but is he strong enough to stick with Ivey? Yes, he is. He is all over Chris Ivey like the ivory on the walls at Wrigley Field. They go into turn number four simultaneously, and leading by Obama Stas is a two of Curry. Looking for a seat on the bottom, trying to create havoc at Wake Burrows. He was complaining about a very tight race car last week. He is running strongly in the number two position.
Yeah, Burrows leading the charge on the outside behind him. It is Garrett Denton. Then we have Sembrook and Cassidy. So the outside linebacker is being on the ball. Burrows slips into the second spot.
Wake Burrows has had a lot of difficulty. That is a great looking race car. So right now he is a strong second, and a man out of the move on the outside is Garrett Denton. Denton said this time he wanted to beat Cassidy by a fraction of a second. He is beating Chris Ivory to the punch as he is able to whiplash his way into third. And I'm almost losing it was Ivory. You saw that little bit of a raise for that 06, and he loses a spot to Jeff Sembrook, one of the most consistent drivers in the division.
Ivory drifted up the track and almost passed Kim Cassidy.
Cassidy Jr. This battle is deep in the field. It's the best.
accident, and he says the car is better now than it was earlier in the season. But it has to be a little bit of a love tap between himself and Canfield, almost setting the 93 out of control, and it helped him in the momentum department and over the flash for Panarone. He said he had something tonight for Cassidy. Right now the question, does he have something for Ray Christian III?
Does he have off turn of the floor right down to just 9 laps left? Cassidy trips again on the 26 or 7. Those 2 laps.
Cassidy could be chittles off the back bumper of the Jeff Sipple car as they roll through the way off the corner. It is still Garrett Denton, determined after losing a nail biter last week. Cassidy going to the outside looking for some adrenaline. But right now we have two youngsters, Denton and Sipple, providing the 1-2 punch.
And Cassidy will try his attack now. He moves to the inside of Sipple. Can he find the way underneath? Not there yet as they go to turn one.
Between the 62 of Mark Cornarelli and the 93 of Ray Christian, as they stop across the line, it is still Denton. Now Cassidy trying to move into second. He has track position against Jeff Sipple, but a yellow comes out, and on the grass is Chris Garside in car number 83, and a car to take on Wednesday nights in the X-Car division. And I think it'll be just a matter of time before he starts proving himself in the mini stocks. Right now, it's a moment of truth for the men in the front row, Garrett Denton and Jeff Sipple. Ken Cassidy running third alongside Doug Curry to put his foot on the gas pedal. Dave Barabold
to put his foot into the lead. It has to be Garrett Denton. Sipple